Praise God. Thank God for that, Prophet King. You know, next year we're going to have our service a little different. Prophet King and Evangelist LaTasha is not going to know when Evangelist King is going to ask them to come minister the word. So I'm not going to give you a heads up. Be also ready. You hear that, LaTasha?
Yes, ma'am.
There's going to be a change, okay? But I thank God for what Roger said, that God has graced us according to his will. Now, my husband has an anointing of a pastor and a prophet, okay? The gift anointing God given me is that of an evangelist. Now, a pastor is someone who shepherds the flock, the sheep. Now, the particular anointing he's given me is an aggressor. I'm an aggressor. I remember when I wasn't even serving the Lord, and I would be at work. If you give me a task, I put my whole heart into that task, and I do it. And I do it so well that maybe someone who had been assigned to do that particular job would become jealous of how they saw that I could get the job done. And I remember this one man told my supervisor, I don't like Terry because she's aggressive. And that thing always stayed with me. So now I know that's a gift that God has given me. Because when it comes down to the enemy, you have to be aggressive against the enemy. Now, those of you who will be tuning into the archive this message, you may have observed the way my husband ministers. It's completely different than the way that I minister. That's why you shouldn't have a favorite minister. Because again, God graced us according to his will, according to the skills that and specialty that he has given us. There's a purpose why he ministers the way that he ministers. There are people out there that needs to, that maybe he can only reach with the way, by the way he ministers. Then the way that I minister, you may see it's totally different. And that's because God had got certain people out there that only him through me can reach those people. But again, the type of anointing that he had given me is the aggression anointing. That is an anointing that is against sexual demons. Have you ever wondered why in the church they always had sex as a hush-hush case? They would talk about everything but sex. I remember that as a young girl, I was a virgin. And I would come to church and I would just be waiting for the pastor to mention something about us young girls keeping ourselves pure before the Lord. But he would never make mention of that subject. So instead, I had to learn about that subject from my peers. And that's the worst place you could ever learn as a child about sex is from your peers, because they don't know. They don't even call the proper names of the body correctly. So anyway, I used to wonder, why couldn't the pastor never talk about a young girl keeping herself pure, you know? And that's because that was a trap of the enemy to bound the church, So here you have all these many years, sex being a hush-hush case in the church. So therefore, people had to go out in the streets on television or wherever just to learn about sex. And that was the wrong place. The best place for your child to learn about sex is in the church. It's in the church where it could be taught properly and in order. There's a proper order for it. But Satan has caused it to be a hush-hush matter. And by doing so, he has imprisoned a lot of people. Why? Because even in the church, from something at this pulpit going to the back door, Satan has already, as a child, have caused people to have become molested at such a young age. But they're not saying anything about it because they fear if they say anything about it, people will just judge them. Misjudge them. Now I'm talking about pastors, starting at the pulpit here. You would be surprised at the number of pastors who are in sexual sin. Now they in this pulpit, and you think in their mind, you see, like LaTasha, a beautiful young girl. Now you think they're looking at LaTasha through the eyes of Jesus. They're looking at LaTasha through lustful, sinful eyes. Already took off LaTasha's clothes, and LaTasha is standing there with her clothes on. But in their minds, LaTasha don't have no clothes on. This is what's going on in the church. You hear me? In the church. Same thing with the females. The females come to church. Don't let a brother come in and give his life to the Lord. Don't let that brother come in. Oh, that's my husband. I tell you, there was a young girl who the devil told this young man was her husband. And the man was already married. So when she went to this other girl and told this girl, she said, well, how can the Lord tell you that he's your husband when he's already married? Well, honey, she said, come on, pray with me that that marriage be broken up. This is what's going on. And she's on Facebook. This young lady's on Facebook with a crowd following her. This is what's going on in the house of God, dear heart. And God is fed up and he's tired. Now, you know Satan don't like no one like me, because I'm going to open my mouth and proclaim the good news of Christ Jesus. Because like Roger said, you don't know what I went through. As a young girl, I was also molested. I was molested. You hear me? I was molested as a child. I didn't know until I was 16 when the Holy Spirit brought to my remembrance this small, tiny memory. And I was shocked. And I was like, what? And I went to my grandmother and my uncle's wife, the one who molested me, and I mentioned to my grandmother and my uncle's wife. Now, my grandmother, which is his mother, did not believe it, but his wife did. And then when I confessed to that thing, I know known to me my aunts, because I had aunts and uncles younger and probably a couple years older. She heard me, and she was surprised, and she said, he molested me too. And come to find out, he had molested all of his sisters. All of his sisters. To this day, dear heart, I have one of his elder sisters, and I do believe now that was a demon through her that had confessed this thing to me, because then I was not in the Lord, but I was going to make a trip to Africa, and for some reason she called me, and she didn't never call me, because really she never liked me and never liked her, because I knew that she was a witchcraft worker and that she hated me. But for some reason, she called me, and she congratulated me going to Africa, and I said, thank you. Then all of a sudden, she switched the conversation, and she began to tell me about this very same uncle, which is her brother, that molested her, and went into details about it. Dear heart, I do believe that was a demon, because to this day, she don't even know she confessed that thing to me. That was a demon. So you have all that going on. Molestation. And that's the reason why once you start getting older, you start involving yourself in when you think you're masturbating, but you don't realize there's a spirit being that's actually is following you. And the Lord told me that masturbation is a spiritual orgasm. Just like in the natural, you have physical orgasm, but masturbation is a spiritual orgasm. Only difference is you just can't see your partner. Not yet. If you continue to enjoy that masturbation, you eventually will start seeing the effects of that partner, because it will lay in the bed with you and the bed will go down, but you looking there and ain't nobody in that bed, but you see the mattress going down. Now, I ministered deliverance to this pastor a couple of days ago, and he confessed to that. When I mentioned to him, he said, yep, that's right, that's what happened to me. He said, I was laying on the bed, and the bed went down, and nobody was there, but the bed went down. See, that's that spirit partner. Then if you continue to accept that, it will manifest in the natural realm. Take on the appearance of a human man or a human woman, the appearance going to be beautiful, going to look beautiful and handsome, and it's going to manifest to you, and it will have sex with you. And dear heart, this is happening. Now, you think this sounds like a horror movie or something that maybe we just see on a haunting that may not be true. Dear heart, this is happening. Now, again, you may start seeing them in the dream. a man coming to you, a woman coming to you, in the likeness of an old boyfriend, in the likeness of your spouse, having to have sex with you. That is that spirit lover. That's a spirit lover. Again, if you accept that dream, it's going to say, oh, good. Because what it's trying to do, it manifests itself just a little to you so that you can receive that little, then it'll manifest a little bit more and a little bit more, but it really wants to take on the appearance of the human being and manifest that way. Now remember, their aim is only to kill and destroy and to steal one destiny in Christ Jesus. When they manifest to you in those ways, in this natural realm, things never going to go right. Never. You know, if you marry, you may stay married for a year, 2 years, you may, but eventually you end up divorced, and that's why you got so much divorce and marriage in the church. Then it'll get in start working against you in your job. You wonder why people all of a sudden just take one look at you, just don't like you. You know, even you try to get other relationships, that's not going to last, because that spirit going to make themselves, no, here you are. Now, Natasha's free now, praise God, but I'm using her as an example. I'm a man. I'm looking at Natasha. When Natasha had that spirit husband, there were some men that looked on Natasha. They would see Natasha, but then all of a sudden they would see this other face looking like a man, and they jumped. And they won't have nothing else to do with Natasha. Natasha will try to talk, oh no, I see you later, Because it's that spirit say, you belong to it. This is what's happening in the church. And this is something that Jesus has anointed and appointed and gifted me with. I did not ask him for this knowledge. I did not ask him for this specific anointing. This is something that he have chosen to give me. I know Satan, through a lot of people, say, I wish the evangelist king would hush up about that matter. Well, if you got that thought, who is telling you to say that? Is it the Holy Spirit? No, that's those spirits. That's those spirit spouses. That spirit husband, spirit wife in you, if I get on your nerve when I talk. I remember before I got delivered, the demon was living in me, and I didn't know. And there was a woman of God that would come on TV. Now, I could listen to her mother, but when she would come on, oh, it would agitate me, irritate me. Can't stand the way that woman talk. There's something wrong with her. Click. Turn the TV off. I always said there was something wrong with her. And then when the Lord had mercy, he's such a loving, graceful God. He had mercy upon me. Because I had no idea that that spirit, and that's why I'm so adamant against demon spirit, because they could be in you and you're not even aware of it. All you know is people tell you, why are you acting like that? What you mean acting like that? How did I act? What did I just say? What did I just do? Well, that's evidence that a spirit is in you, in control. So the Lord, his mercy and grace, He spoke to me one morning. He said, Tara, would you go to the women prayer? I said, prayer, bro. I said, yes, Lord. He said, when you go, he gave me instruction. He said, when you go, I don't want you to eat like most of those women are going to do when they go to women prayer. When praise and worship start, I want you to stand up, hold your hands up, and you worship me. He said, I'm going to send a woman of God to you. She's going to lay her hands upon you. Now, Lord specific told me these instructions for a reason. Because he knew if he didn't tell me that this woman, that he was going to have a woman to lay hands on me, I wouldn't allow her to lay hands on me. So he told me, so that's the reason why I allowed it. I said, yes, Lord. So I asked my husband to take me, and he carried me. And so when we went, and sure enough, the praise and worship started. Women were just eating. They were just eating. I put my plate aside, I stood up, the Lord said, because he said, I don't care if you're the only one standing up looking foolish, you hold your hands up and worship me. I said, yes, Lord. And so everybody was just eating, and I just put my plate aside, stood up, held my hands up, and I began to worship him. I began to worship him. I gave him my heart. I surrendered to him. I worshiped him. And as I was worshiping him with my eyes closed, I could feel the wonder of God watching and looking. And then she came on over where I was at. I literally felt her coming over where I was at. There was another lady who came with us beside me. I guess when she saw me standing, she stood. But see, her heart was not in. It's because you see someone else do something, and you try to do it, but your heart is not in it, Jesus is going to pass you right on by. Your heart must be in it. So the woman came, and I felt this good. She just was happy because she thought the woman was coming to her. The woman bypassed her and came to me. Keep in mind, now my eyes are still closed. And she came to me, and she began to pray for me. And as the Lord said, she put her hands upon me. And then she put her hand on my belly. Then she began to talk. But dear heart, do you know when she began to talk, I did not hear her. I heard Jesus talking to me. Jesus was talking to me, using her mouth, her voice, but talking to me. So here I was trying to listen to Jesus, but something was hindering my hearing. I couldn't hear him as clearly as I desired. But my desire was so strong in hearing him that I kept trying to hear him with all my might, but something was trying to stop, just trying to block me. And I said, Lord, I can't hardly hear you. Could you speak up? Speak up. And the Lord would not speak up. He kept his same tone. I said, stop. I said, Lord, I can't hear you. Could you speak up? He did not. He kept his same tone. And he began to tell me about myself. He told me even who he compared me to with in the Bible. He's like giving you a bold spirit like Joshua. That's what he told me. He would tell me all of this. And I was just trying to listen, listen. But then all of a sudden, the woman of God put her hand on my belly. She put her hand on my belly, dear. When she something came to attention. You ever heard evangelists say, come to attention?
Yeah.
That's that spirit. That spirit came. I want you two ladies, come on forward. Come on forward now. Come down because the anointing is strong in Jesus' name. God's going to do a mighty work. That woman put her hand on my belly, and the devil had to come to attention. Come to attention in the mighty name of Jesus. When he came to attention, the Lord God Almighty cut fire right now in Jesus' name. Come out, come out. Holy Ghost fire, burn. Burn in Jesus' name. Come out, come out. Holy Ghost fire. Come out, spirit husband. Come out, Jezebel. Come out, snake. In the pick of her, in the mighty name of Jesus. You have no more legal hold. You have no legal right. You have no legal right. Come out of her belly. Come out of her belly, snake. Come out in Jesus' name. Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire, set a blaze, Jesus, from the crown of their head to the soles of feet. I command every spirit, you are not of the Holy Spirit, to loose God's property. Loose them and let them go. Holy Ghost fire, burn, 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 burn. Burn in Jesus' name, burn in Jesus' name, burn in Jesus' name. Burn all manner of darkness and evil out of the mind, out of the will, out of the emotions, and out of the body in the name of Jesus. Because the blood of Jesus set them free. Fill them with your spirit, Father. Fill them with your spirit, Father. Fill them with your spirit, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. Fill them with your spirit, Father. Set their body ablaze. Flush them by your fire. Flush them by your fire, Father. Flush them, Father. Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you. Be free. In Jesus' mighty name, be free. That woman put her hands on my belly, and when she did, that thing came up and out of me. In Jesus' mighty name. Be free. Be free, my daughters, in the name of Jesus. For Jesus Christ died for your freedom. Jesus Christ died for your freedom. He died for your freedom. He died for your freedom in Jesus' mighty name. You are free. Free in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Father, we thank you. We thank you for your amazing grace. We thank you for your mercy, Father. Father, we thank you because your desire, as you told me, you had some of me, but you didn't have all of me. You have some of your daughters, but you didn't have all of them. But this day, Father, you have all of them, Father. And now they can worship you in spirit and in truth. Your sins are forgotten and your sins are forgiven in Jesus' mighty name.
Thank you.
You are free. Amen. So let's say thank you. Let's say thank you. Glory. Glory. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Glory. Glory.
Young lady.
Glory.
Every lie that the enemy told you in the past 6 weeks, every lie, the Lord says to forget every bit of it.
Amen.
Now, act like it never was spoken in Jesus' name. Because if you go back and dwell on it, you're going to revert to a month ago. I don't know who you are. I don't know what. My wife don't tell me nothing. And I prefer it that way.
I don't know who you are either.
Okay. All right.
They're a child of God.
But the Lord says, let it go. Move forward. Walk forward.
Amen.
Just like the last part of the message, you were tested and tried by fire. You passed the test. But keep it moving.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
You are free. But I want you later to come. Just give a brief testimony of who you are and how you find out about it.
Okay. Hold on just a sec. Worship. Lord says that your time of worship, it's when he appreciates you the most. He appreciates you, but in your times of worship, you really get his attention.
Amen. Amen.
Don't let anyone hinder your worship.
Amen.
Whether it's your job, your family, or even things you want to do, don't let it hinder your worship. Worship is key.
Amen. You can come first, thanks. I just
want you to give your name and how do you find out about us,
and just give a brief testimony of what
the
Holy Spirit just did.
Praise God. My name is Erilyn, and I'm from Atlanta, and I've been struggling. Well, my heart's desire is to be closer to the Lord, to hear his voice, and I just feel like there's just been spiritual hindrances throughout my life. My family comes from a family of Catholicism. In the past, I've dabbled in the occult. My great-grandmother opened the door to witchcraft. The curses were put on her, and she changed from a normal, sane woman to an abusive woman, and all the women in my family don't seem to stay married. They don't seem to get married. And I feel like, you know, I might have been the first one to actually come to the truth in Christ Jesus. But I felt like my main focus was I want a father and a husband for myself, my three children. And I feel like God calls me to spiritual warfare, but I've been feeling a spiritual prayerlessness. Like I can't move forward in prayer even though I know what to do. I just can't seem to do it, couldn't seem to do it. And God led me to Evangelist King's YouTube video on spiritual husbands. He just dropped it. I didn't know why I was searching, what I was searching for, but what caught my attention was that she was an American. And she was in a teaching setting. And I said, I only heard the spiritual husband come up in fiery prayers in the African community.
Right.
So I was very interested in hearing what she had to say. And from then on, I just listened to all of her videos and heard the testimonies of deliverances, and I always felt like I just need hands laid on me for deliverance.
Amen.
And I praise God.
Today, baby. You are totally free.
2 days ago, he led me to her site, her events, to see if she was having an event, and it was like 2 days. He just made it happen.
Amen.
So, praise
Amen.
God.
Amen. Glory, glory, glory.
Praise God.
Amen.
Praise God.
Come on, baby. Thank you. Amen. That's why I didn't even ask, because I know God sent them. And usually I ask, but Lord said, don't ask this time. You tell me, come on forth.
My name is LaTasha. This is my
spiritual sister here, and we have been for over a year with another sister praying and just doing everything that it takes as far as marriage when it comes to being faithful to God and being in prayer and abstaining and different things like that. We came from Atlanta, 6 hours we drove here.
Wow.
So that we could have hands put on us, like, and a deliverance from spiritual soul ties. We've been battling with the spiritual soul ties. We've been battling with sexual predators. I know in my family, sexual predators moving through my brother and different things like that, was molested, and some of my children were molested. Even in school, my daughter was sexually abused in school, and so it's like, it's just like a predator moving throughout the family. Even in my mom's family, they were molested, so it just keeps running rapid, and it just seems like we have been tied up to something that we keep trying to break and destroy. And I receive that in Jesus' name.
Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you. And I have some books, a book I'm going to give you to. Now, do you have the children?
Yes, I have two.
Okay, your children. So what I want you to do when you go home, put your hands on your children. And you can read. Natasha, look at my bag. Get me two of those good. You can read those. Say those 5 prayers over your children. Okay. Now you love your children, but you be aggressive against. You should be aggressive against those spirits, because you see what those spirits have done in your family. Mm-hmm. So in this book are the 5 prayers, and that's your free copy.
Okay.
You put your hands on your children. Because God, His aim is to set the whole family free. And they are told, you two are totally free. God, God heard you. Now, usually, as I'm telling Natasha, usually I ask a person, the Lord said, don't ask them, I sent them. Well, I said, you come on. You come on. Praise God. They come all the way from Georgia.
Yes.
You know, I felt somebody's supposed to have come. You know, I was sitting there waiting and waiting and waiting. And I had my husband do the service because I knew the anointing would be very strong. Because if I'd done the service, then that kind of would have tied out my body. But God wanted to preserve my strength for this time. Because you think when you're under the anointing, the body feels it. It's fine as long as you are under it. But once you come out of the anointing, you can feel it, the body. It ties out the body because this is flesh. This is flesh. So it is finished, it is done, all evil curses have been severed, broken in the family by the blood of Jesus. Just take it and receive and go by faith. Go and share what God has done for you. Share what God has done for you. Now you two are two beautiful women. And Natasha tell you this, beware of these men, even in the church. Especially you, because you have just like Natasha, and you beautiful too. But she got this unique beauty about her, like Natasha. Be careful. These men in the church, they're not where they should be. Tasha, you can tell them. They would look the role, play the role. But you better ask your Heavenly Father, who loves and cares for you, to let you see the spirit that man has yielded the members of his body in obedience to. Don't go by this outward look, because I'm telling you, outwardly the man look handsome. But it's what's on the inside is what you're going to deal with. So who is he yielding his members in obedience to? Father, show me that spirit. And you'll be standing there. And he will sometimes physically let you see that spirit. And you'll be like, I told many people the same thing. And it actually happened. Like this one younger man, when a woman came up to him, from here on up, she was a human being. Down, down, she was a snake. See, that's the spirit that's in her. So you have to ask your Heavenly Father, because you don't want to get tied up and locked up and bound to no man that have a spirit wife. Your marriage will be hell. Your marriage will be hell. The Lord said, be aware of that, okay? Mm-hmm. Because now you are totally separated, you're totally delivered, and Satan is going to try to send some man mm-hmm. to stop or hinder what God just did for you. Mm-hmm. And I don't care when you go to bed at night and you dream, and maybe a man continue to dream, trying to have sex with you, and you wake up. Don't dwell on that. You just say, Father, I thank you, because by faith in your word, I know that I'm free. And you forget about that dream, and you worship the Lord. That's that spirit husband trying to get back in through the dream. If you be aware of that, okay? Just remember your blood covenant right in Christ Jesus. Just call on the blood of Jesus. The devil hates the blood of Jesus. And I want you to go to each other's house. I should have bought some, but not more. But by faith, I want you to open up that front door, and both of you say, in the name of Jesus, every spirit that is not of the Holy Spirit that's living in my house, I command you to leave my house. You go from room to room. You say, Holy Ghost, fire, burn. Mm-hmm. Go from room to room, Holy Spirit. Burn everything in my house that don't move, walk, talk, sound, or act like you. Go under the bed, over the bed, go in every closet. Don't leave no space untouched, Holy Spirit. Mm-hmm. Everything that's not of you, drive it out by your fire. And those devils got to get on out. Because the Lord said, they are in there hiding. Mm-hmm. They are in there hiding. You say something.
Just go ahead and wrap up, and you can finish ministering them after this runs out. Okay. About to run out.
The Lord said, they are in there hiding. And that's what I want you to do. You go to her house, and you go to her house. You two do it together.
Give her the bottle. Give them the bottle you have.
Okay, you can go ahead and use this. It's a normal one. And I'll just get another. Okay, amen. Thank you, baby. Natasha, you can close it out. You don't have to do the honor.